start off with the first question. How did you and your husband be first meet?
We met on Match.com. Yes, we did.
Well, it's funny that we met on Match.com. We were both a little nervous, but we both wanted to see it through. So we had our first date, and we continued to talk on the phone for hours.
We have a lot in common. We love the Steelers. We love watching football together. We love our dogs. They're the center of our life, other than my kids. We love cooking. We love working outside. We have a lot in common.
I just felt like she was the girl that I wanted and was looking for in my life. A lot of common interests.
She means everything.
And she means everything to me.
She's my best friend.
And we enjoy doing a lot of things together. Our passions are outdoors, animals, and cooking. And that means a lot to me.
Mike, I am blessed and honored to have met you. I feel so lucky that we're going to be sharing our lives. I'm excited about our future, and I can't wait to see you down there.
If I had to choose between breathing and loving you, I would use my last breath to tell you that I love you.
Thank you. and invite you all to stand, please. Everybody, you may be seated. Well, we're here today. I think we're going to get married, aren't we? Friends, we're gathered together in the sight of God to witness and bless the joining together of Michael and Diane in Christian marriage. The covenant of marriage was established by God, who created us male and female for each other, and with His presence and His power, Jesus graced a wedding at Cana of Galilee. In His sacrificial love, He gave us the example for the love of husband and wife. And today, Michael and Diane come to give themselves to one another in this holy covenant. So now I ask the two of you, in front of all these people who have come here to share in this wonderful day with you, I ask you now, in the presence of God and these people, to declare your intention to enter into union with each other through the grace of Jesus Christ, who calls you into union with Himself as acknowledged in your baptism. So first I'll ask you, Diane, will you have Michael to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him and comfort him? Will you honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? And if you agree with that statement, your answer is, I will. Very good. That's the right answer. Michael, will you have Diane to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her and comfort her? Will you honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? And if you agree with that statement, your answer is, I will.
I will.
Very good. Now I'm going to ask all of you who are gathered here. It's a charge for each of you. The marriage of Michael and Diane unites two families and it creates a new one. Will you, as their families and as their friends, will you give their blessing to their marriage, and will you pray for God's grace to fill their home? And will all of you, by God's grace, do everything in your power to uphold and to care for these two persons in their marriage? And your answer is, we will.
We will.
That's a pretty good answer. Frankie, you can go ahead and give your mom a hug or a kiss or whatever, but you may have a seat. Would you bow your heads as we pray? God of all peoples, you are the true light that illuminates everyone. You show us the way, the truth, and the life, and you love us even when we are disobedient. You sustain us with your Holy Spirit, and we rejoice in your life in the midst of our lives. We praise you for your presence with us, and especially in this act of solemn covenant, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I'm going to read from Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 through 14. Hear these words. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Amen. When Michael and Diane and I were meeting in my office a while back, I said, this is just kind of get-to-know-us time. We're going to talk about logistics of the wedding and all that stuff. But I said, you need to tell me some things about yourselves. And I said, like, how you met? And they said, well, we met on Match.com. And, you know, that's a lot more common than it used to be. I've done many, many weddings where people have met online, and they're very compatible. I said, well, you met together. I said, tell me when you first talked, what that was like. And it was interesting because they shared back and forth, and they said there was no awkward silence. We were able to talk for hours, and I said, like, how long? Oh, 2.5, 3.5 hours. They said they love to cook together. They enjoy working together inside the house and out in the yard together. They share a passion for animals, dogs in particular. We were talking about relationship and what their sense of marital relationship was like. And, you know, I was assured that this was not something that they had just rushed into, but they talked about patience. They talked about commitment and how important commitment is to a covenant relationship. If you want the judge to marry you, go next door. Okay? That's where the courthouse is. But I do that part, but I also do the covenant portion. This is covenant relationship between God the Father and Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit. And they talked about an investment in each other and in covenant relationship. They also said things like ongoing work. One of the things I like is that they're independent individuals. They love each other. And they're anticipating this new life together as husband and wife. And they both love Sunday football. I was a little disappointed they were Steelers fans, but, you know, I'm a Cowboys fan because I'm from Texas, but, you know. God has blessed them in finding each other. This has been a long process. This is a God-ordained process. This is covenant relationship that they're joining in together here. Marriage is hard work, but they're committed to each other. They're committed to the marriage and to Jesus Christ as well. I ask that you would bow your heads for just a moment. Eternal God, you're the creator and the preserver of all life. You're the author of salvation, giver of all grace. Bless and sanctify with your Holy Spirit Michael and Diane, who come now together to join in marriage. Grant that they may give their vows to each other in the strength of your steadfast love. Enable them to grow in love and peace with you and with one another all the days of their lives through Jesus Christ our Lord. And the people of God said, amen. Amen. Would the two of you step up here in the chancel with me? And then if you'll turn and face each other and join hands. You don't have to remember all this. I'm just going to prompt you line by line. So, all right. Michael, you're going to say this to Diane and repeat after me. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I'm Michael.
I'm Michael.
Take you, Diane.
Take you, Diane.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
And now, Diane, if you'll say this to Michael and repeat after me. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Diane. Take you, Michael. To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. As long as we both shall live. This is my solemn vow. Who has the rings? These rings are an outward and spiritual and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace. It signifies to all that the uniting of this man and this woman in holy matrimony through Jesus Christ and His holy church. Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may live in your peace and continue in your favor all the days of their life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, Michael, if you'll take this and slip this onto Diane's left hand on her ring finger, and then you'll repeat after me. Diane.
Diane.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, Diane, if you'll take this and slide this on Michael's left hand on his ring finger and repeat after me. Michael.
Michael.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
Father.
And of the Son. And of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And if the two of you would step up and light the unity candle, remember just to go ahead and light the tapers first. Diane and Michael have come forward now, and they light these respective candles that represent each of their families being joined together as one. And from two distinct individuals comes the joining that makes them one together. Got to fix your train. There you go. That's her job. The two of you will turn and face each other and join hands. Michael and Diane, you've declared your consent and vows before God and this congregation. May God confirm your covenant and fill you both with His holy grace. Now that Michael and Diane have given themselves to each other by solemn vows with the joining of hands, the giving and the receiving of rings, I pronounce to you that they are husband and wife, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. Would you bow your heads for a moment? Eternal God, you have so consecrated the covenant of Christian marriage that in it is represented the covenant between Christ and His holy church. Send therefore your blessing upon Michael and Diane that they may surely keep their marriage covenant, and so grow in love and godliness together, that their home may be a haven of blessing and of peace. Bless them in their work, in their sleeping and in their waking, in their joys and in their sorrows. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Would you receive this benediction? The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the presence of the Holy Spirit be with you all, now and forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, before you get to kiss your bride, I have some instructions. Yeah, just relax. Yeah, just relax. You're all invited to the Georgetown at 6:30 p.m. Is that correct? Any other announcements I need to make? No? After the couple has recessed, we're going to take them out of your sight for just a moment. We're going to ask that you all would step outside onto the sidewalk. They're going to be handing out the little... Bubbles. Right. Yeah. Thank you for finishing my sentence for me. With all that being said, Michael, you may now kiss your bride.
Can I do it now?
You may now. You may kiss your bride.
I'm Mike's friend. And I've talked to Diane a few times on the phone, so we haven't met yet.
Okay.
And Diane.
Long time.
May I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Michael Weitzman.
Coming.
You want to get him?
My bro.
His bro.
Yeah. So proud of this guy?
I'm proud of you, man. It's your day.
Yeah. Yeah. One more with Diane. Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
You want to be out in the app?
Yeah.
All right. Okay.
Did you get the reception tonight?
We'll see you.
Hey, I want that crown royal back.
Which one's Joe? Which one's white?
Oh. I got my eye on your crown royal bag.
You get that one?
I need to get this one.
These are all my nieces and nephews.
Yeah. We're good.
And okay, you guys. He only stinks for a minute.
No, I think it landed on my lips.
Thank you.
Okay.
Is
it Carissa?
Yeah.
Okay. Come on,
honey.
What's up, y'all? Come here.
Okay.
We have to
go back, yeah.
Yes. And if this doesn't look good, we'll fix. Okay, maid of honor and best man. Don't move.
One more.
Maid of honor and best man. Okay, hold your flowers so your belly button is covered. Perfect. Help her hold the flowers. Okay. You look happy. I don't even have to tell you to smile. Okay. Okay, everybody right here. Let's do one more in case anybody was burping or smiling wrong. Okay, don't move. Come on up. Funny boy.
There you go. Don't start singing. That's all I ask.
Okay, how about you hop up and get back here, sister? Okay.
Beautiful.
Dad, move in a little bit. That's good. Right there. One more. Okay. We're ready to go wherever you want to go.
Okay. Well, hopefully we can hit the park.
Is that where you want to go?
Yeah.
Okay, where are we going in the park?
Rose Garden.
Okay, fine. We'll see you there.
What? Where is Rose Garden?
I told you. We have no keys to get in. You just have to have stuff. So sense.
I brought everything in the crown roll bags.
Oh, they, Joey has it?
I have it.
Is it in here?
Okay. Yeah.
I don't know. Cheryl
has it.
I wasn't looking for it.
Carol.
How are you?
Yeah. And give us his blessing. Yeah. Then he got us a wedding card.
How nice.
I know.
Thank you again, John.
Yeah, John. Thank you.
Driver?
Yes.
Okay, here. I'm Mike. Nice to
meet you.
We have a couple extra seats.
See you later.
How many
guys.
Does this take? Grandma, go.
Yeah.
Mom, you want to go? Anybody want to go to the Rose Garden with us?
We're going to bring Grandma some lunch. We'll be down there.
Okay. Is Dad coming in the limo? Or are you going with you?
Come on, Mike.
Put that, Grandpa.
Hey, Grandma.
Hope you can handle that out.
Grandma.